This is the story of two young guys, bound in friendship and in destiny. Ronald and Skinny, as often happened, went out for a picnic together to spend the day in the neighborhood countryside. Suddenly, Ronald pulled a couple of little plums out of his basket and gave one of them to his friend. Delicious. Deliciously. Lethal! Note how the slow motion makes everything more epic. The boy's corpse stayed there for hours, enveloped by blades of grass, until all of a sudden, something happened. A new spark was instilled in Skinny's body, reduced abruptly to a skeleton, and slammed him inside Ronald's wardrobe, cursed to watch over his friend for the rest of his days. Or at least until today, when our story starts.
Morning, sunshine.
Hi, Nat. Forgive me, but I didn't sleep very well tonight.
Are you sure you really want to talk to him?
I have no other choice.
He'll have a heart attack if you ask me, and he'll end up keeping you company in the wardrobe.
I really hope not. Do you know where Ronald's gone?
Everybody left a couple of hours ago, but I don't know where they went. They were all very nervous. I don't know why exactly.
It'll be the usual sale at the mall. The Mother Superior must have straightened them up as usual. When will you stop eating those things?
Would you care for some, maybe?
How many times do I have to tell you that I'm allergic to plums? Just looking at them, I'm getting hives.
Man, you don't have any skin at all. And anyway, they're nuts. Otherwise, why would Ronald have given me this name?
He probably just wanted to be alternative.
You're a lost cause.
Hasn't Ronald spoken yet?
You should know that by now. He hasn't said a word since you died in front of his eyes.
I don't want his soul to be damned forever. If that stubborn guy won't open his lips for himself, I'll take steps to loosen his tongue.
Don't hurt him too much.
I have to run to the bathroom. All this excitement loosened my bladder.
I like this room.
Start here then. Put the little pet in the van. In the meantime, I'll prepare the boxes in the living room. And don't do it like last time when you got hit by a car while loading the stuff.
There are color books on the walls!
But you don't even know which side a book opens on.
I like colored books.
Do you know what I don't like? Working for free to pay for broken things marked fragile. Do you understand?
This carpet! It's soft as a marshmallow. I like marshmallows.
I should have listened to my dad when he told me to be a florist.
Ah, I really needed a shower.
Boss, it won't open.
Let's keep working on the ground floor then. In the meantime, I'll ask the lady about a key. I'm afraid this damn move will take longer than expected.
Move? And what should I do now?
I'm coming. Apologies for the delay. I was late with a tutorial of another video game. Players are not what they used to be anymore. Let's cut to the chase. I'm here to explain the game controls to you.
Well, I'm not interested.
I'm not asking you, Skinny. Let your player decide. Perfect. Let's start with the basic commands. The mouse left click is used to move around your surroundings. When interacting with hotspots, holding the button and then releasing it on one of the available icons will perform the accompanying action. Try with the chainsaw.
Don't ask any questions, believe me.
Skinny, try to be a little more accommodating. This is a tutorial. Now try to open the green satchel. It was the wrong interaction. But don't worry. This is used to pick something up. I would like you to open it instead. There is something inside the satchel. Try to pick it up.
Ma, there's gold in this here bag. Ah, no. It's just pyrite.
Don't be fooled by appearances. It could be more useful than you can imagine. For some hotspots, there's only one action available. So a left click with your mouse will be enough. Try to check out the bin.
Was this really necessary?
The player asked for our help. It's important to learn the game controls. Now let's take a look at multiple choice dialogues.
We already saw them on our own.
These constant delays are embarrassing. Well, what else?
Holding the central button of the mouse or pressing space, you'll see all the hotspots with which you can interact.
With the mouse wheel or pressing tab, you'll open and close the inventory.
That's all. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm in a rush and I've got to go.
Is that it? I never saw such a sloppy tutorial.
You're right. It's just that I'm busy like you wouldn't believe. See you soon.
What happened to my wardrobe? I can't be separated from my wardrobe. It's a matter of life or death. Well, I mean, you know. Do you think this is the right moment to play games? Man, what an epic fail. I absolutely need the help of someone stronger than me. I've got no other choice. I don't know what's more disgusting, this or the hair removal strips of Ronald's mother. You have to understand, the bear is convinced he's married to the duck. Watch and see.
Bones off! Don't you dare violate my lady! Plums!
Et tu, Brute?
Bones off!
Bullseye!
Have you seen, boss? I opened the door.
Bravo, well done. But now let's go, it's lunchtime.
I like eating.
Then come on, move.
What a blow. Just like at the water park, only with different bacteria. Now I understand the electricity bills with all the zeros at the end. And this is why we complain about youth unemployment. Nice place you have here. Were you and Tutankhamun relatives? No, it's because I see a strong resemblance. Maybe it's the nose. I could have sworn it, you know that? Did you have an accident with the cat? You must have really driven it mad to need all those bandages. I got it. You're a Tibetan monk under a vow of silence. Damn it, I was sure I was right this time. Were you one of the Queen's guards? You won't confirm or deny it, I understand. Has anyone ever told you you're really good at listening? Seriously, don't be so modest. I would stay and chat with you for hours, but I wouldn't presume to impose upon your time. My grandpa worked in a factory welding vehicle body parts. I remember that on his deathbed, and completely blind already, he mistook the blowtorch tube for my grandma's arm. May he rest in peace. If by any chance you're asking me to drink it, well, don't count on it. A dusty beer mug. A dusty beer mug. Cheers! Hi.
Hi, little bag of bones.
Please don't eat me.
As skinny as you are, you wouldn't even be useful for chicken stock.
Hey, excuse me if I care about my figure. You don't look too good. How are you?
I have an unbearable pain in my tooth. Something must be stuck in it. Would you like to take a look at it?
Fine. That's okay. There's something in there indeed, but I don't think I can remove it with my bare hands. I'm sure you're a really nice guy at heart, right?
Actually, I just escaped from a maximum security prison for reptiles. I was locked up because I slit the throats of my neighbors with a fishbone. They were too loud, and I couldn't sleep.
I promise, I will never do anything to upset you.
I'm just messing with you, stupid bag of bones.
You're not funny at all. See you around. That's where that door led, and for all these years, nobody ever bothered to force it. He seems to be a bit short on energy. Hi, little robot.
C1 is not programmed to talk.
But you just did it.
C1 is not programmed to explain itself.
What if I took out your batteries? Would you still be in the mood to show such attitude?
C1 is programmed to run on solar energy.
Don't provoke me, or I'll hit you with a hammer. You're looking worse for wear.
C1 isn't tired. C1 is running data.
Why don't you turn tail in the meantime? If those two catch you, you'll end up in a box, you know that?
C1 is not programmed to do it.
Are you telling me you can't do two things at the same time?
C1 hasn't got the updated firmware.
Right, everybody says that. Is there any chance you can give me a hand unscrewing a knob in the room upstairs? You know, my sedentary lifestyle inside the wardrobe left me a little out of shape.
C1 isn't programmed to help others.
Well, actually, me neither.
Beep, beep, bzz, bzz. Beep.
C1 finds this really insulting. C1 has had it up to his valves with you.
Come on, don't be so salty. Don't forget we applied for a PEGI 3 rating. Be careful what you say. What about the three laws of robotics?
C1 thinks you've seen too many sci-fi movies. C1 could easily pierce your skull with a laser beam and use it as a bowling ball if he wanted to.
I'll keep that in mind. Thanks for the clarification. Good luck with your calculations. As unbelievable as this sounds, Ronald's father bought it years ago in anticipation of his own funeral. He found it on sale at a mortuary fair. He won't be happy at all when he finds out those morons have damaged it. It's the old alarm clock Ronald used when he was a small child. Didn't think he still had it. It's a hard life for hitchhikers. I really have to ask you this. Looking for a lift to the 9th Underworld? Surely someone could give a good cleaning around here once in a while. When Ronald moved into this house, the forensic guys had just unsealed the kitchen. When the investigation was closed, his parents decided to leave the outline of the body on the table. I have to admit that it gives an extra kick to breakfast, though. A couple of pots, some ladles, and jars with spices of dubious geographical origin. How did this get in here? I never tasted anything so delicious. I know where this is going. With this trick, we lost 4 relatives and 8 of the cat's 9 lives. That critter won't get closer to the living room, even under torture. I confess, I've always been curious. An ending so unexpected.
Just another small interruption to tell you that it may sometime be possible to pick up the same object more than once.
Another belated circumstance where you show your negligence. But thanks for the tip. It's a sort of big ball of dust. And who the hell are you?
Have some respect. stupid bony human! You're looking at the future conqueror of the world!
Only dumb characters in this game. Don't laugh, that goes for you too. Jumping Jiminy!
Not me! I can't jump! I have no legs! And my name's not Jiminy!
I meant, where did you come from?
From under the hardwood floor. I was stuck there for years, but now I'm finally free and will have my revenge.
Who do you want to take revenge on?
The world. I have nobody to take revenge on in particular, so I will take my vengeance out on the world.
Can't argue with that. Listen, not to curb your enthusiasm, but you look pretty harmless to me.
What?
I mean, you don't look blessed with any particular abilities, or of great intellect, or any intellect. You can't expect to get very far without a well-constructed plan.
You're right.
How about a spider bite?
A bite?
You're right, it wouldn't work. You're already full of mites, and it doesn't look like they're helping you. Maybe with a bit of radiation? Though, come to think of it, I don't think the green would look good on you. I got it! This calls for a nice potion. After all, if it worked for Obelix, I don't see why it shouldn't work for you too. At the very least, you can always opt for an emergency solution, Iron Man style. What do you think?
I didn't understand a single word!
It's a deal then. Who would be your nemesis? The Swiffer?
I don't know any Swiffer.
Forget it. I have to go. Bye. I found the solution to your problems. Mainly because if I waited for him to solve it, I would have died another time first.
What am I supposed to do?
You just have to open your mouth and say,
Okay.
I feel a great power in my hands. Wait a minute, I have hands!
Sounds more threatening already, right? How do you feel?
Better than ever. I feel like I can break the whole world.
Just try to take it over, okay?
Huh?
Unfortunately, it seems we haven't made any progress regarding intelligence. What about the Swiffer?
I don't know who this Swiffer is, but I will punch him to death!
This should be interesting. Now you seem to be covered in muscles and not by dust anymore. In my opinion, you're not so strong after all.
What are you talking about? Don't you see I'm a beast?
It doesn't seem that way to me.
Test me then.
Okay. In the room next door, there's a bed. I bet you won't be able to unscrew one of the knobs.
It'll be child's play. Is this the knob?
It's not a crystal ball, that's for sure.
I don't get it.
Yes, that's the one.
It's up to me and you now, Knob.
Thank you.
Hi, Bear. What's new?
Nothing, since I'm forced to stare at the sink. Hope I'll be luckier in the new house.
Do you want me to give you your happy pills?
How many times do I have to tell you that I don't need them? Besides, I have my duck. She makes me feel good.
How do you feel about this move?
I hope I don't end up in a bathroom in front of another dripping sink, or I'll go completely crazy. You better find a way to get out of this house and into that van. What are you waiting for?
Did you see Ronald?
If you mean naked, yes. Every single day. And it's not a pretty sight.
Come on, Bear. You know very well what I meant.
Early this morning. Usual time. He was a little down in the dumps. I mean, more than ever. But nothing particularly suspicious.
Have you had any other hallucinations since the last time?
Luckily not, Mr. Hunter.
Bear, I'm skinny.
I'm just messing with you. You're the little wuss without a backbone.
I would argue that claim. Now I have to go, Bear.
I guess so.
Is this yours?
Ha ha ha. Very funny.
Not exactly the luckiest fishing trip I've ever seen. Backup is coming. Open your jaws and no funny business.
It's so liberating. Kind of like when I escaped from prison.
I don't know if you're being serious or you're just spectacularly trolling.
We'll never find out.
Please, give me just one second. I just realized this is the first time I've been out of the house since I died. Okay, I think I can manage. Let's go. It must be a slot machine gas station. I think I'm living proof of how awfully wrong this all is. Living, so to speak. I don't feel like rummaging through the dumpster. A huge sleeping guy stands in my way. I don't know why, but I'm having the strangest case of déjà vu. I don't think I can wake him up, and I don't want anyone to see me in this outfit anyway. You should be able to recognize Nut by now.
Took you long enough,
And where did you pop up from?
This van is a wreck. I got out through a hole hidden in the floor.
Is there a way to get in from under there?
Negative, dude. My head may be huge, but nowhere near like yours.
How about taking a ride with me?
All aboard!
He seems a little anxious to me. Dogs and bones aren't the best combination. It would be better to leave it alone.
With our bare hands.
Even his blindness never gets him down. Sorry, sir. Can I bother you for a second?
Don't you see? I'm really busy right now, boy. Are you blind?
Tell me this is a joke. What are you doing exactly?
I'm working, unlike all those incompetent slackers.
But you are blind.
Not at all. I can see perfectly. I don't need anyone's help.
Which number am I making with my fingers?
4.
Okay, at least now we know we're not dealing with one more fake cripple. You really have strange taste when it comes to clothing.
Brown and black are absolutely classic, boy. Timeless.
But actually, you...
You young people today don't understand a thing. Go back to your hipster flaps and pursue a living in bad taste.
Your tenacity is very impressive. So, do you ever stop?
We need someone who keeps everybody up. I can't afford to rest. It's hard work. Someone has to do it.
And when, for example, you need to go to the toilet?
I always carry my traveling catheter for emergencies.
I really need to go.
I'll see you around, boy.
Hey, that's a banana, not a hammer.
If you have a gangster past, maybe now's the time to mention it.
Union for people like you. Back in my day, the screws were tightened clockwise. Come on, let's get a move on!
Dude, have you lost your mind?
It's not my fault. Don't blame me.
I don't understand.
When we were at war,
forget
it. We dug the pits with our bare hands! Hey, that's a banana, not a hammer!
He took a really nice flight, no doubt about it. I like to consider it more like using a cheat than a burglary. After all, we're still in a video game, right? I wasn't holding my breath on it being open.
Oh, you finally did it then.
When you use nice manners, you get everything you want, Nut.
For a moment, I assumed the worst. We need to celebrate. Take this.
How the hell often do I have to tell you I'm allergic?
It's a damned nut! Do you even have eyes in those sockets?
Something stinks here.
It wasn't me.
I mean, where the hell did those two go? I'll get out. I have to check.
Isn't it a bit late? Have you checked the time?
Yeah, from that clock, boss. You can relax. I like lunch breaks.
Too bad that pendulum has been stuck for years. A little souvenir from Easter Island. We had some trouble at customs, but it was worth it. Sorry, but I need you to return my chewing gum. Let's wait to make sure they don't look in this direction. Let's wait to make sure they don't... I can't. They would see me. I can't. I can't. I can't. I can't. They would see me.
Those two are still not coming.
What are they doing now? I'm going back to take a look.
Better set up the timer to guarantee an escape route.
The water is tickling me. I like it.
Come on, let's get back to the van and get out of here.
I don't like these kind of days.
You're telling me. If I find out who pried my van open, ugh.
Remember your heart condition, boss.
You're right. Let's just think about delivering everything and forget today, okay?
Are you ready for the new house?
I haven't even thought about it, actually. I just want to talk to Ronald as soon as possible.
Why all this rush? Sorry, but I wasn't paying any attention earlier. I was too busy with my nuts.
Basically, according to otherworldly laws, the perpetrators of a blood sin will be condemned to eternal damnation when they die.
But Ronald's was an accident.
That doesn't change anything. It's irrelevant. The only way to prevent this from happening is to confess his crime to someone else. Within 5 years.
And how much time does he have left exactly?
3 days.
And you're just thinking about it now?
I didn't want to overwhelm him. I wanted to give him his space.
I really have no words.
Spoiled brats. Hey, boy, is everything okay? Tell me, that fall cut out your tongue?
No, sir.
Isn't it too early to wear your costume? It's only afternoon.
What?
You probably hit your head too hard on the ground. It's Halloween today. Otherwise, why would you wear that stupid skeleton costume?
Yes, of course, for Halloween, obviously.
Bah. Try not to make too much trouble while you're still around. Capiche? Brats.
Where the hell am I? Did someone throw my wardrobe in a dump? Okay, calm down. I know the address of Ronald's new house. The problem is getting the wardrobe over there. It's incredible how many crazy things you can find in a dump. King Kong smoking a pipe, sitting triumphantly over Godzilla, probably defeated single-handedly, and with a Death Note in his hands. The amount of epicness on this float is impossible to calculate. I'd like to honor you by pounding my chest, but I'll get no more than a xylophone sonata. A rather unusual place for a hydrant.
Hey boy, you finally woke up. You know you could have broken your neck. This is not a fun fair.
This isn't the first time you've tried to make me rummage through the rubbish. What strange perversions you have. Waste, waste, and waste again. Hey, wait a minute. Seems Santa Claus came early this year.
Not bad, this map. Did you know that you can open it at any moment by pressing M or selecting it from the top right corner of the inventory?
And what are you doing here? Are you some sort of stalker?
Please, I'm just omniscient. I don't want to disturb you further. Good luck with that wardrobe.
How did I get here, precisely?
How the hell am I supposed to know?
No, I meant, who brought that purple wardrobe here?
Wardrobe? I thought it was a coffin. Two guys from a moving company with a white van full of old junk.
Old junk? I need that wardrobe.
I don't live in this waste for fun. If you want something, you must pay.
But I have no money. How much do you want, exactly?
Let's settle it this way. As an exception, if you pay the crane costs, you can take the wardrobe.
What if I use the crane myself, without bothering you?
And what if I use these boots to kick your ass?
Thanks for helping me.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I'm not interested at all in your health. I just wanted to be sure a dead brat doesn't get in my way.
Then you shouldn't even be talking to me.
Did you say something?
Ah, forget it. Post-traumatic ramblings. I see you love black magic. Are you some sort of wizard?
I don't like that tone. Black magic is neither shallow nor vapid. It's real art.
Of course. I didn't think for a moment it wasn't. And do you ever wear the pointy hat with the little stars?
At the birthday parties.
Well, aren't you tall, eh?
My grandpa put steroids in my baby food when I was a kid.
Okay, this time I really put my foot in my mouth.
Hey, I meant what I said.
I better go. See you around.
Don't get into any more trouble.
That shrill voice makes my skin crawl. I mean, my bones.
Don't provoke me, or I'll wail even louder!
No, please be quiet. Clowns and their abundant sympathy. Better wait until it gets dark, when everyone will be in costume. All clear. Wow! An American party! I would have never expected to see Pinhead with heart-shaped boxers. Let's see. I could sing him a lullaby. Lullaby, lullaby, ooh, who will I give this baby to? I'll give it to Santa Claus and he will drink it in his house. I'll give it to the old witch and she will fall into a ditch. Everyone knows she can't handle her drink. I'll give it to a complete fool, and he will slip into the pool. I'll drink it with my stupid friend, and all our money we will spend. Happy alcoholic dreams, little star. He doesn't exactly seem like a smart guy.
Hey, flea! Don't make me angry or I'll beat you up and make you regret being born.
Bullying tendencies, and a clear deficiency in basic language skills. Another point for Skinny.
What do you want?
Why are you so angry?
Upstairs is close, and we can't do hanky-panky with my blondie girlfriend upstairs.
Given the circumstances, I'll volunteer myself as interpreter. The room on the upper floor is closed, so my girlfriend and I can't find a place where we can have a little alone time. The second upstairs is redundant. How come the door is closed?
That stupid Johnny Blonde is there with his brunette whore.
That unintelligent blonde man Johnny has shut himself in the room with that morally loose dark-haired girl. She must be quite famous around here. Bad story, yep. Listen, since you can't go up there, why don't you give me a hand getting a wardrobe from the dump?
Bite me.
Tasty refusal. What if I find a way to clear the room?
Why not?
I suppose in this case, I can accept. Okay, don't move and don't abuse that girl while I'm gone.
I'm not drinking booze.
Yeah, nice. No booze. I better go now.
Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds. That is when the world will end.
He doesn't look very reassuring. Sorry, were you calling me?
Are you Donnie?
My name's Skinny.
They told me the guy was a bit mad, but now I've had enough.
Can you tell me what you keep saying?
Nonsense I need to say to learn that crazy Johnny. He seems to love a good public rambling.
Try using a mousetrap.
You're not funny.
Who said I'm trying to be? I know it's none of my business, but can I ask why you're looking for him?
Are you Donnie?
I already told you my name's Skinny.
Then mind your own business.
How can you be such a bastard?
I can do anything I want, and so can you.
It's really fun around here.
I think it's deadly boring, with extremely loud music, people dancing, or getting hammered with beer. Jeez, very original, huh?
What else is there to do around here, then?
I'd personally prefer quieter places. If I were you, I'd go to Roswell Pond or the beach. I even saw a complete lunatic who said he invented a time machine. Do you believe in time travel?
I wouldn't know. I've never thought about it.
It seems like nonsense to me.
Why are you wearing that stupid bunny suit?
Why are you wearing that stupid skeleton suit?
Actually, I'm... Forget it. See you later, Playboy Bunny.
See you later, Lindsay Lohan. A storm is coming. I'm... Here. Come. Come closer. Minutes, 12 seconds. That is when the world will end. A storm is coming. I'm here. Come. Come closer. Seconds. That is when the world will end. The storm is coming. I'm here. Come. Come closer. Thank you.
This is the sort of unexpected surprise that suddenly earns Christianity points in my eyes. I didn't know he was a Sauron adept as well. It's strange Tolkien never mentioned him in any of his books. I have nothing so important to ask to interrupt him. After all, I stopped believing in him a long time ago. I prefer to let him focus on his beer pong. That hair would turn even Amy Winehouse pale. The last person I saw at the bottom of a bottle like this was Ronald's father during Christmas dinner with all the relatives. It's been slung directly into the oven. A historical video gaming relic. Literally. I hope it wasn't delivered in this condition. Watch the ceiling fan. Don't have too much fun up there, old pal.
Egon, tell him about the Twinkie.
It's gone. It fell into the tea while I was dipping it.
I mean the big one.
That's classified information. You know that. You should really stop drinking for the night, before all this caffeine pushes me beyond the capacity for rational thought, too.
Never wake a Mexican guy from his siesta. Never. I remind you that the single time she spoke, she burned up an entire lab. Still sure you want to talk to her?
Check this out. We have guests. Let me welcome you to my little gloomy abode.
For you, author of this video game, from now on you can count on my unconditional hate. Nice to meet you.
My pleasure, believe me.
I don't want my sweater stained by puke, thanks.
Be quiet, or my husband will hear us.
Cracker. Cracker. Come on, stupid bird, repeat it. Cracker!
You brainless moron biped, my intellectual capacities are way superior to yours.
What did you say?
Cracker! Cuddle me.
Express Courier, 24 hours, 7 days a week, 00845891. All packages must be impact-proof, water-repellent, and the contents must be clearly indicated outside the box. I could pack up the wardrobe and ship myself to Ronald's new house. Those polka dots are obscene, to say the least.
Be quiet, or my husband will hear us. Cuddle me, stuff. I love when you...
He was waiting for the Half-Life 3 release. right in the feels. I'm definitely not a military forces expert. My knowledge stops at Gunnery Sergeant Hartman. What nice sharp fangs! Would you be so kind not to eat me?
Hey, two. Do you know what's round, soft, and juicy?
A tomato?
No, stupid. A nice child.
How many times have I got to tell you? I'm done eating children. I'm a fruitarian now.
And what the hell does that mean?
I only feed on fruit, and just the ones that fall from trees to the ground.
You won't last more than a week.
You'll see.
You're really the black sheep of our family.
So many possible spoilers, I wouldn't even know where to start. So many possible spoilers, I wouldn't even know where to start.
Dude, don't be sad. Actually, I get your life choice perfectly.
Really?
I eat only children.
He's undoubtedly the life of the party.
That fall into my mouth.
It's always a pleasure to see you. Quite a nice place you got here for a barbecue with family. Oh, sorry. I had no idea. And yet I can't imagine that an attractive mummy like you... Don't beat yourself up. I'm sure you'll find your soulmate. You just have to be patient. Now, I really have to go, Mr. Silence. If only it was charged. Little impertinent kid. He has a bright future ahead of him.
Ooh.
You're having fun, eh?
Tyler didn't want me in the way, so he closed me in here. I had to do something to fill all this time.
Tyler?
My older brother. He's the guy who arranged the party. I was bored, so I thought it would be fun to scare anyone who walked into the storage room by mistake.
If I was in your shoes, I would have done much worse. Where did those come from?
They're the posters for a Horrorbilly concert that will be held tonight at the old cemetery. My brother didn't want any interference for his party, so he tore down as many as he could. The whole neighborhood was practically wallpapered with them.
Absolutely not. Among us nerds, there's a code of honor. One of those old rag dolls people played with once upon a time. My grandma would have crawled through glass to have one of these when she was young. With your permission, I'll take it, Boogie.
Go ahead. You earned it.
Days.
That is the strangest form of meditation I've ever seen. Excuse me? Mister? I don't want to bother you, but... Damn it, old man! I am talking to you!
Your approach is ill-suited for a civil discussion between adults.
You're right. I went too far.
I forgive you.
Don't you think you're a bit too old to live in a treehouse?
Verily. I have dwelled here for 63 very long years.
Oh, sorry. I had no idea.
Be not ashamed, boy. I forgive you.
How come you made this life choice?
Modern society did not befit me. The decay of values, the rotten logic of capitalism, wars generated by the interests of politicians, the inept or mind-washed public. Yet I am sure mankind has learned from such foolhardy mistakes over the decades.
You'd be surprised. Are you really sewing your beard?
Incorrect, boy. I am knitting it.
Why would you want to do something like that?
I produce eco-clothing for important fashion brands.
What about that story of how modern society doesn't suit you?
When one's moral beliefs undermine personal interests, send them to hell.
I don't understand this obsession you have with saying I forgive you. You must be a person of unsurpassed goodness.
In truth, I am not, boy. When I was a mere lad, I was besought to play a priest for school theater. People rushed from all the neighboring towns to grace us with their presence. Everything proceeded perfectly, and I felt the pride swell in my then tiny body, covered in a black robe. But alas, during the third act, the confessional collapsed upon me and hurt my head. People were greatly dismayed when they saw the little minister on the ground, senseless. I hung betwixt life and death for 2 whole days, and then I awoke. Ever since, I cannot resist uttering, I forgive you, all the time.
Yes, very interesting. I'm a terrible boy. Could you please forgive me?
You are indeed, boy. 'Tis not appropriate at all to make fun of an elderly man. And yet, I forgive you.
I'll leave you to your extremely busy life.
The door of my dwelling will always be open to you.
Especially since you don't have a door. Wake up, old man!
You needn't shout like that.
You're right. Excuse me.
I forgive you.
Listen, could you maybe sew some of this hair on the head of this doll?
An unusual request. But I perceive no reason not to indulge you. Give it to me.
Too kind. Thank you.
Automatic lighting system activated.
I have the vague impression that someone here lost their inspiration.
I didn't know how to name him. Am I right?
You didn't know how to name what?
You. It's your name.
No, I have no name.
Maybe it's precisely because your parents didn't know how to name you.
Perhaps.
So I'm right. That's your name.
I already told you it's not my name.
You should get yourself in shape again.
Why do you say that?
Maybe because you can't even get out of your burial plot?
I just put myself on a diet. I haven't touched a pizza in weeks.
Only because he devoured the errand boy too, last time.
What happened to your arm?
I was too hungry, and I bit it.
It must have really hurt.
But it was good.
I'm assuming you're a cannibal, then.
I make no distinction when there's food involved.
You don't mean to try to eat me too, right?
If they were all like you, I'd have starved to death by now.
Actually, you're right. I'm going out for a walk. Maybe you can join me later, okay? Black magic for daily consumption. Chapter 1. Witchcraft. How to curse your mother-in-law and live happily. Capture a wild animal to associate with the victim. 80% of readers pick a toad or a snake. Wait for midnight and the moonlight to baptize the animal with her name. Free your mother... I mean, the animal. In open country. Your beloved acquired mummy will thus lose the power of speech. Remove the earplugs and enjoy the new silence. Achtung! Unfortunately, the above-mentioned witchcraft is not effective on wives and husbands. Chapter 2. Seances. How to satisfy your edible complex even if your mother left you. Sit around a table with other people who want to communicate with your dead mother. Therefore, avoid inviting your wife. Light up a wax candle in the center of the table. Create a circle, holding hands or touching with the pinkies. At this point, close your eyes and evoke the dead towards you. Some dead people don't like to talk, so prepare an alternative medium like a pen or a typewriter. Achtung. Always remember to avoid antagonizing the dead if you want to communicate with her once again, but mostly avoid antagonizing your wife. Chapter 3. Voodoo practices. How to get revenge on the school bullies while keeping your distance. Recover some hair or nail samples from the concerned bully and attach it to a doll. Then place a voodoo doll in the center of a pentacle. Close your eyes and channel your hate on the bully. Imagining him with his head in the toilet increases the chance of success. If the ritual is successful, the doll will assume the features of the designated victim. Grab a needle or some pins to stick into the voodoo doll. Enjoy your revenge. Achtung. Don't damage the doll by removing its limbs or head. Keep out of reach of children. What ugly mugs.
Speak for yourself.
Did I just imagine it, or did that head say something?
Nothing at all.
Very good. For a moment, I thought I'd gone mad. They come up with all kinds of excuses to mask their hoarseness. But that's Grandma. Ronald's grandma, I mean. I hope that even after her passing, her mole vision hasn't improved much, so I can still pass myself off as Ronald.
Damn my age.
Ronald, Grandma, sweetheart, you came to see me? You're so emaciated. Are you eating enough?
I do eat, but the weight ends up only on my butt.
You have the same body structure as your father. That do nothing.
Grandma, didn't you have yourself cremated?
Do you really think I'd let them lock me up in a vase? I corrupted the gravedigger by telling him to fill the urn with chewing gum.
I noticed that.
Your favorites. Anything for my little Ronnie.
It'd really be too much for her. What is Grandpa doing over there?
He's been trying to get out of his coffin for days now. Except every time he forgets to watch his head.
Well, at least he leaves you alone.
It's about time. It wasn't enough for him to torture me when I was alive. I didn't even have time to die before he felt compelled to do the same.
I'll come back and visit you very soon, Grandma. The most useful object a galactic hitchhiker could have.
Wait a minute, Ronald. It's dangerous out there. It's full of atheists. Take this.
The scientist must have seen too many Doctor Who episodes. That blood does not bode well at all. Is this your time machine?
Yes, but it is still an experimental prototype.
The usual excuse is to say it doesn't work.
It'll work. Just watch and see. And finally, everybody will stop saying that I'm just a crazy, stutterer, anemic guy.
But you're not anemic.
That's what I keep saying myself.
What are those blood stains you have on you?
Oh, not a big deal. A little accident while I was working on a different project.
How many did you kill till now?
Don't be silly. I conduct experiments on dead bodies.
Dead bodies that were alive before, by any chance?
If there's really shortage of raw material, those too.
You seem to be pretty eager. What are you waiting for?
I ordered a new carburetor online. The old one was damaged during my previous attempt. And it still hasn't arrived yet. They'll get an earful from me at the customer service of thatcrazyscience.com.
You can really find everything on the internet these days.
You can't even imagine. People are really out of their minds.
I'll come back later. See you then. A black man who gets a tan from moonlight? You're kidding, right? Just because we're in an adventure game, that doesn't mean you get to bother whoever's around. I can't even imagine how his back came to be in that state. I'm noticing a suspicious resemblance. Go back to the nether realm, vile creature of Satan.
You're the worst exorcist I've ever met.
It would seem to be a metallic disc stuck in the rock. I really don't know what to say. It's a child's dream coming true. What are you guys doing?
We happen to have a scam underway. A big scam. We couldn't stand our demeaning and not at all gratifying job as office workers anymore. So we spent all our savings to buy this cave that we accidentally dated back to the Neolithic, complete with cave paintings.
You're really an evil mastermind, no doubt about it.
You mean we are really evil.
The cave painting idea might be set aside.
What do you mean?
Look for yourself to my right.
I'll be darned. This will be worth a lot of money. Neolithic my foot. Come on, let's go. We've got work to do.
Finally, some really intelligent life forms. On the house.
You can never say no to a drink.
Yes, good boy. Drink.
Kayo.
Don't look at me that way. I had no other choice. Look at him. He's sleeping like an angel. A few hours of sleep won't be bad for him. He was too stressed. Okay, negative thoughts. Nothing easier. All because of how easily I can project my complete hate of other people. One of the few advantages of my skeletal form is that I'm unaffected by electric shocks.
Hmm. 8 days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12...
This is shaping up to be very fruitful fishing, finally.
I can't believe you did it.
I am a real pro. What can you do?
Why don't you take a look at your pockets?
How on earth did you do it?
When you spend your life escaping from the IRS, you can't survive without certain tricks.
And how did you end up running a carousel?
Social services. Anyway, with that coupon, you can collect a prize of your choice at the Gypsy Kiosk just outside the city. Oh, I almost forgot. Be careful going around with that other little bag I gave you.
Oh God, what other little bag?
I was just joking.
You're not funny at all.
Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds.
He must have a very bad case of photophobia.
The world will end.
Good evening, how's it going? My name's Skinny.
At last. Welcome, please. Come, sit.
I suppose you haven't noticed there's only one chair, right?
You see, you may have spent the last few years of your life looking for me, but I have spent my entire life looking for you.
Actually, we just met. Not that I have any objections, but I don't think you'd be my type anyway.
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back.
I thank you, decline your offer, and move on. What happened to your eyes?
Nothing. I know why you're here, Skinny. I know what you've been doing. I know because I was once looking for the same thing. Mirror lenses. Rimless sunglasses, limited edition.
Why are you reciting the Trinity lines?
The answer is out there, Skinny. They're incredibly cool.
I don't see you having much fun.
Do you really want to know why?
Yes, I would like that very much.
Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
Come on, cut it out and tell me.
I forgot my pill.
Pill?
My blue pill.
Ah. You should really try to relax a bit, if I may.
Do you believe in fate, Skinny?
Here we go again. No, I don't. Answering with something relevant for a change?
Why don't you believe in fate, Skinny?
I don't like the idea of being born just to be killed by a plum. And right at the beginning of puberty, by the way, without even having time to... experiment, so to speak. What are you doing around here?
It's not important. Let me tell you why you're here. You're here because you know something. What you know you can't explain, but you feel it. You felt it your entire life, that there's something wrong with the world. You don't know what it is, but it's there, like a splinter in your mind, driving you mad.
Please, go pick up some girl like all the normal people. You'll see, you won't think about it anymore.
I can't.
Oh, right, the thing with the blue pill again. Now I've really got to go.
Before I go mad as well.
And we'll be screwed if at least one of us doesn't remain sane around here, right? Am I wrong, or is he the alien that got lost?
Look at Grandpa.
Congratulations! Great music! I don't think he can hear me. He's a human being. A belt would be useful. What is it? Postmodern art?
Nah, you're right. I really can't come up with nothing interesting.
Like what?
Well, bro, I don't know.
Something that conveys strong emotion, gets people's attention. Something that grabs you, but original once in a while. Tired of riding A-cab on the monuments, yo. You hear me, bro?
I'll think about it. Maybe I'll have a good idea.
Sweet.
Sorry to bother you, but you seem familiar.
You probably saw me in a game show in the past. You know, I was a pro gamer once.
Judging by how you're doing now, it seems something went wrong.
Carpal tunnel. I slowly lost mobility and reactivity. It cut me out of the pro circuit.
I imagine more like an arrow in the wrist or something like that.
Arrow in the wrist?
Never played Skyrim?
Sorry, just beat 'em ups.
Then you suffer the proper punishment. You probably came all this way just to find some peace. I think you just found the most useless hotspot in the whole game. I suppose I should ask her for my prize. Hello?
What's with a concerned face? You never saw a puppet before?
Sure, but not one handled with invisible strings by a headless puppeteer. And able to speak, by the way.
Do you have a problem with me not being controlled by strings?
Well, no.
And maybe it's illegal for a puppet to have a nice voice like mine.
That's not what I meant. You women are really impossible. I won a coupon at the carousel.
Choose your favorite prize.
Anything?
Anything.
I'd like a cartridge of the E.T. video game for the Atari.
I gave out the last one just yesterday.
No harm done. It's the worst game in history.
But you're in luck. I can give you this.
In this video game, some phrases are a bit too literal. Let's have a look. How is it possible that all this stuff could fit inside such a small package? Let's just hope this is the right time. This is a cool track. I've never heard it. Too bad I don't know the title. He's even scarier life-sized. Sorry, Charles, but you can't just add me to your collection. The perks of being already dead. I was joking. My time has not yet come.
What do you want?
The bedroom on the upper floor is empty now, as promised.
Really? I'm calling my gang now. Be still her. Take the guys and go to the dump. Don't waste my time. I don't care what you do now. It's all fixed. Go now. Hanky Panky Room is ready.
Wow, they couldn't control themselves any longer. Not bad. Now you really have an aggressive look.
I have to admit it, I'm really pumped for it.
Do you think you can sing a metal song now?
Which one do you want to hear?
Do you know Knockin' on Ronald's Door by Plums and Roses?
I don't think I've ever heard of it, sadly. But the title reminds me of something.
Do you know Livin' on a Wardrobe by Bon Jovi?
I know the band, but not that song.
Do you know Born to be Rot by Steppin' Nut?
Never heard of it.
Do you know The Power of Death by Skinny Goes to Hollywood?
Wasn't it The Power of Love?
That was a song from the Back to the Future soundtrack. I don't know the name of it, but do you know a song that goes like this?
Oh yes, I get it. I love that song.
Are you ready?
This time, I really messed up big time. It's all ready. We can get started.
Where do you want us to take it?
Friday Avenue, number 13.
Do you have any idea how far that is from here? We're heading to the party. The best we can do is take it over there.
I'll settle for that.
Do you hear that? Let's move.
It seems that part has finally arrived. Maybe this might be interesting for you?
Where did you find that?
Here and there.
Okay. Pour in exactly 3 milliliters for every dozen years you want to go back. Add another 2 milliliters to run the machine, and 1 milliliter every half hour of real time utilization. Be as precise as possible.
Okay, no problem.
The machine will start as soon as you have inserted the destination date in the appropriate display. Avoid traveling into the future. The process partly uses the geomagnetic field of the Earth, and possible changes could stop you from coming back. Just remember, you can't jump from time to time. Every time, you're forced to return to the present.
Will you be much longer?
The doors are automatic, so stay in the vicinity. Some animals could enter the machine and come back instead of you by accident. And remember to be careful to never interfere with the space-time continuum.
Yeah, whatever. How much plutonium did he say I have to pour exactly? Well, I'll abound. What's the worst that could happen? Sometimes these professional apple eaters get too caught up in the competition. Bravo! You dug up the date on our website. Are you satisfied now?
Goes there, prithee.
My name is Manny. Manny Calavera. I am the Grim Reaper. I didn't want to scare you, Mr. Manet. Your reputation precedes you, you know.
Well, you flatter me.
But now enough with the pleasantries. That's not why I'm here.
I guess my time has come.
Correct. But not entirely accurate. I could give you a second chance.
Anything, but spare my life. I beg you.
Add me to your painting, then. In the sea, possibly large and highly visible.
But that's a preposterous demand. It would be completely disproportionate. Not to mention that it would absolutely ruin the scene's pathos.
Do I take that as a no, then?
Forgive me, Grim Reaper. You'll have your wish.
I think I see something that glitters in the net. Serves me right. Next time I'd better mind my own business. Inside, there are just apple seeds, but if you really want them...
Smell. You must absolutely take a bath. Grab this.
So elegant. Moving this is proving to be much more difficult than I thought.
Yeah.
Do you need some more bubble bath by any chance? I have a bottle of it here with me.
Okay, you can go in.
You can lay it down on the bubble bath shelf.
If it's any consolation, I had the misfortune of seeing such intimacies, too. What are you doing locked in here?
I'm enjoying some well-earned rest. I work as a security guard at the City Museum, so situations like this don't come around that often. Luckily, Ralph, my cousin, hates Halloween and offered to cover for me.
A security guard for the museum is really necessary on Halloween night?
That's what I told the union. But do you think they listened? Anyway, take this. To repay the favor of the bubble bath. It's a bit wet.
I don't even want to know where you kept it.
The museum is closed to the public, but you can enter with this pass if you find yourself in that area. If you go, let me know if that midget has everything under control.
Only thing missing was the poser dinosaurs. Accept defeat, Rex. You can never compete in a race with the Velociraptors.
Winter is coming.
What do you want?
What about that heart rate monitor?
I'm a heart patient. I need it to check my pulse.
Maybe if you didn't drink so much coffee.
That's easy for you to say. Night shifts here are deadly boring.
Your cousin wanted to know if it was all okay here.
Yeah, right. I have so many unruly visitors to keep at bay. What is he afraid of? The Anubis statues will come back to life?
Small, chubby, and a heart patient. Is there anything else?
Your sarcasm leaves me completely indifferent. You have the reigning national champion of the insult contest in front of you, in case you didn't know.
Nobody and nothing can beat my sharp tongue.
Show me then.
You will never be half the guard your cousin is, that's for sure.
That's more than I can endure.
Behind you, an aortic dissection.
Right in the chest with surgical perfection.
From the look of things, the pumpkin shape on your skull is still visible.
The pain it causes me to talk of that fruit makes me miserable.
Perhaps your heart has been pierced by Cupid's arrow. When I was young, I always dreamed of having one of these all of my own. And I still dream it now that there's one in front of me. Surely the rodeo act that's both most amazing and inappropriate of all time.
With such threatening bows, I can only imagine the effect it would have to face them on the high seas. Oars in their hands, and they go out to have fun plundering vessels. Druidic potions, basically the equivalent of modern homeopathy. It certainly cannot be said she doesn't know how to sit on that throne. You look like you're waiting for someone.
I'm waiting for one of my countless suitors to get the nerve to come forward.
What would keep them from doing it?
Exactly what I've been asking myself. I'm afraid everybody is too scared of my beauty.
The burden of being so beautiful, yes. What should this mythical Prince Charming be like?
For centuries now, I've been waiting. We queens too have certain needs to satisfy. I just want to find a good mummy to spend the rest of infinity with.
That shouldn't be so difficult after all.
Don't rub it in.
What happened to the Pharaoh?
The servants found him dead, poisoned by the bite of a snake. I remember I was so angry with him. Not that the two things were connected, obviously.
Of course, of course. I have a dilemma.
Don't you think you're too young?
What?
You can't be more than 15. Well, it's true that my beauty transcends age after all.
Actually, I didn't want to hit on you.
Do you think I'm not attractive enough?
No, absolutely, you are. I didn't mean to.
You better.
I'll leave you to your undertakings, my queen. I have a letter from Mr. Silence.
What a sweet little wrapped Fluffy. Yes, I think I'll accept his proposal. Let's just skip the small talk and the engagement ring. I have no time to waste. Did you bring the wedding rings? Did you bring the wedding rings?
Your firecrackers or your life?
Do you think you can scare someone dressed like that?
Not even a fly.
Now that I notice, I've never seen a more ridiculous Halloween costume.
Really awful.
I'm afraid I will just have to come up with something else. Nowadays, our generation is too desensitized by TV and video games. Thanks a lot, HBO. Grandma, two kids are out here making fun of me.
Is someone being mean to my little Ronnie? Brats. Don't worry, honey. Now Grandma will take care of them.
You should have seen their faces.
First of all, we extract the gunpowder. And now...
Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds.
I have nothing so important to ask to interrupt him. After all, I stopped believing in him a long time ago. Why should I? To get it signed?
Days,
Hey, honey, look what I have for you. Suddenly, it doesn't inspire all that much fear in me anymore.
You've seen too many Lupin the Third episodes.
You didn't think for a moment that someone might hear the bang of the explosion and call the police?
Six hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds.
Can you turn the music up full volume?
Come closer.
Your museum is still in one piece. Of this, I can reassure you.
My cousin is going far beyond my expectations, then.
Mm. 30 seconds should be enough. Maybe I overdid it with the gunpowder. Done. Why the sad face?
Everyone my own age has bouncy and long hair. What about me? I practically lost mine.
Losing your hair in the 80s is just about the worst thing that could happen. It's always a pleasure to see you.
Quite a nice place you got here for a barbecue with family.
Oh, sorry. I had no idea. And yet I can't imagine that an attractive mummy like you...
Don't beat yourself up. I'm sure you'll find your soulmate. You just have to be patient.
Now, I really have to go, Mr.
Silence.
I have the wedding rings with me, my queen.
What are you standing there for? Find us a priest to perform our wedding ceremony.
Actually, I think I've already done more than enough.
It's an order! We're having the ceremony over at the meteor at the Roswell Lake. What a romantic place. Now go. I have to get ready.
It's best not to get involved in certain private business.
Days.
Listen, son of God, since you're one of the creator's superstars, I was wondering if you could preside over the wedding of a friend of mine.
Well, actually, I'm the owner of that massive franchise of chapels, churches, and cathedrals. Who better than me, right? I'm just a little too drunk. I could use a very small bit of help, but not from above. Because if my father sees me in this condition, I'll have to wait millennia for the next coming. A short review on I now pronounce you happily ever after. Now you can kiss the bride, but discreetly. That kind of thing.
Could this help?
Just what I needed. We'll see you at the wedding then.
But you don't even know where the wedding is.
Brother, I may be wasted, but I'm still omniscient, after all. See you later! By the power vested in me by my father, I now pronounce you man and wife. And now, come back home to update your relationship status on Facebook.
These should be the famous fluffy wrappings of the mummy.
Be quiet, or my husband will hear us.
Express courier, 24 hours, 7 days a week. 00845891. All packages must be impact proof, water repellent, and the contents must be clearly indicated outside the box.
Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds.
I don't see you having much fun.
Do you really want to know why?
Yes, I would like that very much.
Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
Come on, cut it out and tell me.
I forgot my pill.
Pill?
My blue pill.
Ah. Now I've really got to go, before I go mad as well. And we'll be screwed if at least one of us doesn't remain sane around here, right?
That is when the world will end.
I come in peace. I'm calling from Earth. I don't understand anything you're saying. Phone home. Well, I tried.
Yes, hello?
Does this number actually work?
Sorry, Skinny. I can't talk right now.
Wake up, Neo. The Matrix has you. Follow the White Rabbit.
It's 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds.
I have something with me that will make you very happy. What is it?
Red pill. You take a trip to Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
I'm not completely convinced.
It's strawberry flavor. What does the rest matter?
Ah, you're right. Give it to me. I think I'm still tripping. He was right, anyway. Strawberry flavor.
Hey, hi! Welcome to the Ashcliff Hospital.
You gave me a bleeding fright.
Did you come to see me?
Actually, I don't even know what I'm doing here.
Nobody comes here to visit me. Always just the patients. Don't nobody ask for poor Amber. Do you know why I'm called Amber?
I don't care.
It's for the color of my hair.
Compelling.
Were you looking for me?
Not at all.
I can tell you about my day if you want. It's very interesting.
Actually, I'm trying to attract the attention of those three guys in there, but it seems they can't hear me.
You only think about the patients. What did I ever do to you?
Nothing, in fact. I just want to talk with them.
All right. Fine. Farewell.
Guys, there's Skinny.
Hey.
Hola.
Do you know my name?
Skinny, I created you. You think I don't know your name?
Where are we exactly?
I welcome you to our new studio.
We've all gone mad during development of the game. Too much stress and too much work to do.
Especially with Francesco as project leader.
I have a bad temper, I know.
What do you mean you created me?
Skinny, come on. You know very well you're inside a video game. What did you think you are? A love child of two pieces of code in C#?
I've redesigned you thousands and thousands of times, really.
By golly.
What else are you developing now?
Just consider this moment a sort of strange temporal anomaly. We're still working on the wardrobe, even if the game has actually been released for a while.
You wouldn't happen to be working on a sequel in secret, right?
No!
Okay, there's no reason to get heated up. Since you're my creators, I have a couple requests.
We're listening.
I've always dreamt of having superpowers. What if I was able to fly?
No way, too many game design problems.
A bionic arm?
It would clash with the anatomy of your character.
A Hawaiian shirt instead of this sweatshirt?
Handling your static poses and animations would become way too difficult.
And what about...
Halt. Sorry, but you have only been given 3 wishes.
But wishes run out only after they've been granted.
Sure, but I'm not the genie of the lamp.
Why have I been brought back to life?
It's not my place to say. Let the player figure it out by himself.
How can I leave this place?
You just need to keep your eyes shut long enough. And always remember that nobody can see past their own choices.
Are you telling me I'm the master of my own destiny?
Hell no. You're in a damned adventure game.
Days, 6 hours, 42 minutes, 12 seconds. That is when the world will end.
Hello, Hippie Express Courier. How can I help you?
Good evening. I'd like to arrange the delivery of a casket to number 13 Friday Avenue. Expenditures are charged to the consignee.
Are you aware of the packaging regulations of our service?
Tell me.
To avoid damage during transportation, we ask you to wrap the object with a material that can soften impact. Usually, it's plastic or bubble wrap, but you can use any solution you prefer.
Yes, that's no problem.
We also ask that the outer casing of the package is absolutely water-resistant. It might seem a strange demand, but in the past, our drivers have shown a certain fondness for watercourses in this area.
I'm equipped for that too.
And finally, it is necessary to identify the package with a written note clearly indicating its contents.
Yes, Alex, I have the solution.
Sorry, I don't think I heard correctly.
Oh, I mean, no problem.
I'll authorize a courier for your delivery. Thanks for calling us. Goodbye.
I'm waiting for a courier to take the wardrobe away. Could you maybe pack me inside using this kit? I have to create a nice prank.
Dude, I'm always ready to help out with these kind of things. I wish I could see his face. I can't imagine what a fright he will have.
Neither can I. Believe me.
Ronald? Ronald, wake up! Ronald, it's me, Skinny.
Do you really not recognize me? Remember? Me and you were going to conquer the world. We kept on saying that we were meant to do great things. Well, in a way, I guess that happened, but nobody could have imagined all this. You couldn't know about my allergy. Even I wasn't aware of it. Ultimately, there are a lot of perks to being dead. I have an infinite amount of free time, and I can eat everything I want without being worried about my weight. I'm even immune to electricity. Like I'm a superhero. I'm sorry you suffered so much. I know how tough things have been for you since that day. You have nothing to blame yourself for, believe me. I have nothing to blame you for. I couldn't breathe. I just heard you screaming. It wasn't difficult to understand what was going on, but incredibly, that was the last thing I remember. No light to follow, no extracorporeal experience, just a big nothing. Disappointing, don't you think? When I finally woke up, all was dark. It took me a while to realize I was in a wardrobe. In this wardrobe. I know, it's really absurd, but it's the truth. I've been brought back to life, and now I'm a skeleton. You have to go back to talking. If you don't tell somebody about what happened that day, you'll end up being damned for eternity. That's why I'm here. Because I love you, Ronald.
Skinny. Skinny, wait! Don't go!
almost forgot.